Hello, my name is Isaac and I am Chef Dev. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about continuing my enemy AI, getting it to recognize the player, getting it to attack and kill myself. Not literally, of course, just figuratively. So let's get started. After having the Pathfinder, the Idle, and the Wonder States implemented, I moved on to getting my enemy prototype to be able to identify the player and chase him like the murderous prototype that he is. This was reasonably simple to implement since I'd already set up the navigation mesh and the pathfinding, so it was just a matter of detecting the player and setting them as the path target. All I needed to do was set up an area around the enemy that if the player walked into, it would send a signal to activate the chase state. In this state, the player was set to be the path that the murderous enemy would run to. This path updated every second to give the player a bit of legroom to get away and stop the enemy from looking like it knows exactly where to go. If the enemy goes directly to the player without sort of taking any other trips, just makes a beeline, it doesn't look as realistic. We want it to look as natural as we can possibly make it with these tools. This was very simple, thanks to the state machine that I was using. I'd created a class that held all the methods used for setting up a path. This way, I could reuse the code that I'd already set up for the patrol state. All I had to do was pass in the target, in this case being our poor, unsuspecting hero. This is, however, where I started to run into some issues, as at this point there were numerous signals triggering states and other signals telling the path to update, and what I hadn't realized up until this point was that signals triggered code no matter what state I was in. It's kind of obvious now that I think about it, but at the time I was really in this headspace where if I was in a state, nothing else was going to happen. One of the reasons a finite state machine is so powerful, especially for me, is that it helps keep my actions separate. When you're in a state, you know exactly what's going to happen and nothing else can be triggered unless you want it to be. When a signal goes off, it runs whatever line of code it's told to run and it doesn't care about whatever state your fancy state machine is in. So what was I to do? Signals in Godot are like death and taxes. You can't exist without experiencing them, and you can't harness the Godot game engine without signals. Fortunately for me, I know a thing or two about death and taxes, and I was able to solve this issue the same way I solve my clients' financial issues in real life. I smash my head against the problem until either I die or the issue is fixed. Works every time. Anyway, after I recovered from my concussion, I was able to work out that since this was a node-based state machine, I could compare the current state being run against the state the signal was triggered in. If they match, execute. If not, they can scream into the endless void. After that, the problem was solved, and getting the attack to work was pretty straightforward. I keyed in a quick animation so I could see what was happening, and the animation player handled the rest. I added a knockback for when the player hit to give some feedback. It's a little over-exaggerated right now, but that's just so I can tell what's actually happening. I might dial that back as time goes on. And that's really it. Now I have a prototype enemy that can drop into games when required. All you have to do is replace the mesh and animate him, give him some much-needed personality, and you're good to go. I wish I had that. The behavior needs some fine-tuning, and right now these beanie baddies are actually pretty difficult to handle. And I need to look into steering behavior to smooth out the movement, but for now, they're just fine. I learned a lot on this project with enemy AI, and I'm looking forward to using them in whatever project is next. And that's just about it. So thanks for listening. I'm really happy with the way this turned out. If you like this video, be sure to hit that like button, and do please subscribe so you can hear more about my adventures in Godot. Thanks for listening.